Striking a pose with a set of numbers not seen since the Treasurer taking the traditional Budget Day walk was Peter Costello.
The first back-to-back surpluses in almost two decades.
Turning a projected $13.9 billion deficit into a $9.3 billion surplus, following last year's surplus of $21.9 billion.
A second surplus is not an end in itself. It's an important way that we make room to help people.
That help, stage three tax cuts of about $1,900 a year for those on average incomes, energy bill and rent relief and more.
The cost of living relief in this budget will be substantial and it will be responsible.
The most substantial change, an energy bill rebate for all households, not just pensioners, welfare recipients and the low paid, and a million small businesses. Also increasing Commonwealth rent assistance further for pensioners, veterans and others on welfare with one central aim.
The budget will put downward pressure on inflation, not upward pressure on inflation.
The energy and rent assistance predicted to cut inflation by 0.5% this year and defy the Reserve Bank's pre-budget predictions by cutting it back to its 2 to 3% target band before Christmas, bringing earlier interest rate cuts. But some economists say the subsidies might buy a short-term fall in headline inflation, but won't address its underlying causes. Former Reserve Bank member Warwick McKibben saying, you can play political tricks to get inflation at target.
Well, opinions are pretty thick on the ground at this time of year. I don't agree with it.
The opposition does.
This magic pudding exercise by Jim Chalmers, that somehow his assumptions are better than the Reserve Bank's. I mean, nobody believes that.
The politics of this budget, another year of cost of living support, could bring interest rate cuts and much needed relief until July next year, when the tap could be turned off, 2 months after the next election. The centrepiece, the Future Made in Australia plan. Billions in government support to unlock much more in private investment, developing green energy, critical minerals and quantum computing industries, all supporting the government's target of net zero emissions by 2050. The focus now, all on Jim Chalmers' big moment.
Pressure is a privilege.
And tonight he's feeling very privileged and plenty of pressure. Mark Riley, 7 News.
Let's bring in State Political Editor Marlena Wopp now. And Marlena, every dollar will count months out from the Queensland election.
Yeah, Sharon, especially with the third term Labor government facing challenges dealing with housing, the health system and the cost of living. Now, more than $1.5 billion has already been announced for upgrades to the Bruce Highway, as well as the direct train line project on the Sunshine Coast. Cameron Dick has his own budget to worry about for next month, so he will be looking to fellow Queenslander Jim Chalmers for some reprieve, and the wish list is long.
We'd like to see more money for infrastructure, support for our big build across Queensland, more money for affordable and accessible housing, more money for healthcare, particularly primary healthcare, so we can take the pressure off big public hospitals.
Now, another area to watch will be renewable energy. Costs for the Pioneer Burdekin Hydro Dam have already soared. The Miles government wants Canberra to chip in, calling it a project of national significance.
Marlena Wopp at State Parliament, thank you. And coverage of the federal budget continues after the news on 7 with updates throughout the evening before our budget special from 10 past 10.